it's so different, you know. It feels like, oh my God, it feels like a holiday somehow, because in the last 2 years I did a lot of different things and I was kind of out of my comfort zone like almost every day. I co-founded a company, so I got into entrepreneurship and it was very challenging and a lot of fun. It's like amazing. So coming back to snowboarding now, being on the mountain, it's just amazing. It feels like I'm back home, right? I'm back in my comfort zone. So I just tried to get as ready as I could in physical state. And yeah, my first competition was amazing. I was very nervous at the first qualifier, but then I got really back into the race mode. And yeah, you talked about Ramona. I was racing against her and I was very happy that I could keep up with her on the speed for sure. Like I was really slow on the start because of my elbow injury. But other than that, I'm more than happy. I stopped my career doing a live interview at the last Olympics and I didn't even know that I'm going to stop before the interview. And then I made the decision of just following heart and my intuition. And I didn't think that I'm coming back, but at one point somehow life was guiding me back into snowboarding. And now here I am. Right after the last Olympics, I had a knee surgery and a year later, ankle surgery. It was still all injuries from my last season. And I put really all of my power into healing. And this whole healing process kind of got me back, brought me back the motivation and fun for training and sport. And I started with kiteboarding and foilboarding in the summer. And I started with running when I was in Greece on Limnos. And then I just decided, okay, maybe I could do the snowboard tour again. So in September, I was going with the Austrian national team and it felt like really good. And I thought, okay, I'm still have a good speed. And yeah, then somehow my heart made the decision over my mind, I guess. There's a life before, there's a life after the Olympics. Because for me, it was like, as a child, my big dream was becoming an Olympic gold medalist. It was like the biggest dream ever. And reaching that goal was like the most amazing feeling. But same time, imagine you get a medal, but you give your dream away, right? You're losing your dream, but you get a medal. It took time to just retrust, I guess, and to experience new goals and to find new goals. And now I would say I have a life before the medal, a life after the medal, 2 years without snowboarding, and now I have completely different perspective on coming back. And that's very amazing because snowboarding is really a big part of my life, but same time, it's just a little thing, right? Life is so much more than just snowboarding. If I'm honest, I was like, I had no idea. It was just, I wanted to trust my instincts. And the one thing I really can trust on is that I have a fast turn. And I know the feeling of a really good turn. So I thought if I can get back into that feeling, for sure I will be fast. But it's always this getting back into competition. It's different than free riding. It's this 5% you have to give more and extra. And I was not sure if I can do that. So I was really, really happy at the first competition that I got back into this race mode.